Dear student, myself Dr. Kalicharan. Today I am going to teach you about the tetracycline and chloramphenicol, the broad spectrum antibiotic. Now the tetracycline. Tetracycline, it is the broad spectrum antibiotics. Tetracycline, it is a broad spectrum antibiotics. Why it is called tetra? These antibiotics have four nucleus. Antibiotics having nucleus of four cycling ring. It means the nucleus of these antibiotics having the four cycling ring. That's why it is called tetracycline. And this tetracycline is obtained. It is obtained from the soil actinomycete. It was obtained from the soil actinomycete. For remember or to remember, tetracycline, it is used in the treatment of acne. And when acne occur? Acne occur mostly in the teen age group. Tetracycline, to remember, it is for the remember, tetracycline, T for teen age group, and cycline, cyclic period, when the menstrual cycle continue, it is the teen age group, and the pathogenesis occur, that is the acne, and the treatment will be the tetracycline. So thus tetracycline, it is used for in the treatment of acne. And why it is broad spectrum antibiotic? The wide range of microorganisms are being affected. Thus, it is called broad spectrum antibiotics. There are tetracycline, doxycycline, oxytetracycline, and minocycline, as well as dimelocycline. The classification include tetracycline, second is the doxycycline, oxytetracycline, minocycline, and dimelocycline. These are the classification, and the newer drugs, it is the tiagicycline. New drug is the tiagicycline. Thus, now we will study about the mechanism of action of the tetracycline drug. To understand the mechanism of action of tetracycline, that how it acts, the tetracycline acts by inhibiting the protein synthesis. So first of all, we will know how the protein is synthesized. The protein is synthesized by the mRNA. And ribosome, which is two subunits. The larger one is the 50 subunits and the smaller one is the 30 subunits. The larger subunit, which is the 50 subunits, there are two sites. It is the P site and it is the A site. The P site is called peptidyl site. And A site, it is the acceptor site. This site will accept the new amino acid. Acceptor site will always accept the new amino acids, which is attached with the tRNA. These new amino acids remain attached with the tRNA. tRNA means transport RNA. The newer amino acid attached with the transport RNA. Now what happens? From the P site, there is the nascent peptide chains. The newer amino acids will come to the A sites and newer amino acids comes to the acceptor site. It is the acceptor sites. In the second, now what happened? As soon as the new amino acid comes to the acceptor site and get attached with the acceptor sites, there is translocation. That is the translocation or the transfer of nascent peptide chain. Transfer of nascent peptide chain from peptidyl site to the A site. It is shown in this figure that there is transfer of nascent peptide chains are being transferred to the acceptor site, the newer one. It is the newer and again the A1, A2, A3 amino sites are get attached with the new amino acids. And it is, as soon as it is attached, attachment occurred due to the formation of peptide bond formation. It is due to peptide bond formation, there is new chain is formed. As soon as the new chain is formed, there is again all the elongated chains. Here all the elongated chains are being shifted, or it is the translocated from the acceptor site to the P site. It is translocated from the elongated chain, translocates from the acceptor sites to the P sites, and this continue and the protein synthesis carries on. The elongated peptide chain shift back A to P site. As I have told you, it is shifted from A to P sites. This is translocation. Ribosome moves and new protein synthesized with the help of termination complex. Now the mechanism of action. As this is the physiology by which the new from the mRNA the new protein synthesis occur. Now what happens? What is the mechanism of action? The mechanism of action of tetracycline. Tetracycline binds bits with 30S ribosome and inhibit amino acyl tRNA with attachment to the A sites. This is the new amino acid or amino acyl tRNA. This is as soon as it is get attached with the acceptor sites. This process is inhibited by the tetracycline. As the tetracycline binds the 30S ribosome, this amino acyl tRNA, the newer tRNA, it is being inhibited. Thus, to remember, other drugs such as gentamicin, streptomycin, and tetracycline, they all three binds with the 30S ribosome. So, in the it is the GST, G for gentamicin, S for streptomycin, and T for tetracycline, all together binds with the 30S ribosome. Thus, mechanism of action of the tetracycline, that it inhibits protein synthesis by binding with the 30S ribosome. Binding with the 30S ribosome and the protein synthesis is being inhibited. Now, when the protein synthesis is inhibited, the new daughter cells of the new daughter bacterial cells is being inhibited and it is not produced. Now the pharmacokinetics. In pharmacokinetics, the drugs tetracycline, it is taken orally and it is taken in empty stomach. It is always taken in empty stomach, because when if a patient takes meal and this drug is taken, then food delay the absorption. That's why tetracycline is taken orally and it is taken empty stomach. But the groups of tetracycline, doxycycline and minocycline, it is absorbed irrespective of food. It is absorbed irrespective of food. Only the tetracycline is taken empty stomach, but minocycline and doxycycline is absorbed irrespective of food. This drug is given orally. It is not given injectable form, because when the tetracycline is given injectable, it is very severe pain occur, and that's why, and the very poor absorption from the site of injection, that's why in the injectable form it is not given. Important part, that this tetracycline have chelating property with calcium and metals. Chelating property with calcium and metals, as well as milk, iron, sucralfate, milk, iron, sucralfate delay or reduces the absorption. The milk, iron, sucralfate delay or reduces the absorption. That's why patient who is taking or who is on antacid, or who is taking iron and folic acid, the drug, and he needs to be taken tetracycline, then there must be a difference. That time gap, so there must be a time gap for the administration of tetracycline and the iron and sucralfate. So the administration between between the gaps of at least 2 to 3 hours of difference should be present for the absorption. The volume of distribution, tetracycline has got high volume of distribution. That is 1 liter per kg. The tetracycline get highly concentrated. In liver, teeth, and bones. Tetracycline get highly concentrated in liver, bones, and teeth. Whereas minocycline concentrate in the body fat. Due to high fat solubility. The minocycline is high fat solubility. That's why it is highly concentrated in the body fat. Excretion of the tetracycline. The tetracycline is excreted via the kidney. So the dose should be reduced in patient of renal failure. If the patient is in having kidney disease or renal failure, the dose of tetracycline must be reduced. Doxycycline enters into the bile or through the bilateral secretion, because doxycycline also takes part in intrahepatic circulation. And it is excreted through the bile. Whereas tetracycline, it is excreted via the kidney. Adverse effect of the tetracycline. As the mnemonic I have written here, it is the Kapil Dev mnemonic. K for kidney failure. And there is also reversible Fanconi syndrome. In the Fanconi syndrome, there is damage occur in the proximal convoluted tubules. And how the Fanconi syndrome, if a patient takes expired tetracycline drugs, then there will be kidney damage occur, and there will be proximal convoluted tubules is damaged, and it will lead to the Fanconi syndromes. A, that is the anti-anabolic effect. It means it reduces protein synthesis in the human body. There will be negative nitrogen balance, and the blood urea will be increased. Photosensitivity. As I have told you that the tetracycline was used for the treatment of acne, so patient should not go in the sun. And if patient takes the tetracycline, there will be photosensitivity or phototoxicity. It will cause sunburn, skin reaction, urticaria rashes, and in some cases there is distortion of nail, and there will be hypersensitivity reaction. Now I for insipidus, insipidus. That is the diabetes insipidus. Diabetes insipidus means there will be increased maturation. And why there is increased maturation? Because the ADH secretion is reduced. Antidiuretic hormone secretion is reduced. That's why there is increased urination. As well, increased intracranial pressure. Increased intracranial pressure. Liver damage. Alpha, liver damage. If there is liver damage, there will be jaundice and fatty livers and hepatic necrosis. Hepatic necrosis occur and which is fatal. D for dentition, there is defective bone formation. That's why it is contraindicated in pregnancy and in child below 6 year of age. It is contraindicated in pregnancy and child below 6 year of age. Calcium and tetracycline both get chelated and they deposited in the bones. They both get chelates and deposited in the bones. As soon as the bone is being chelated, the body height is reduced and teeth become brownish discoloration. That's why in pregnancy and in child below 6 year, it is contraindicated, it is not given. E for expiry drugs that causes Fanconi syndrome, as I had discussed earlier. B for vestibular toxicity. Vestibular toxicity will lead to the vertigo, nystagmus, ataxia. The nystagmus is most commonly caused by the minocycline. Uses. In uses, we have got RBC in plasma. R for rickettsial infection, in Q fever and Rocky Mountain spotted fever. It is the R for rickettsial infection, Rocky Mountain spotted fever and Q fever. B for brucellosis, it is highly efficacious. In brucellosis, it is tetracycline, highly efficacious. C for cholera. In cholera, tetracycline causes decreased stool volume and decreased diarrhea. In inguinal granuloma, or it is the granuloma inguinali, the tetracycline is very much useful in granuloma inguinali. P for plague and peptic ulcer. In both type of tetracycline is very useful in both type of plague, that is in the bubonic plague and pneumonic plague. Lymphogranuloma verulam and in leprosy, venereal disease when it is caused by the chlamydia causes erythritis and endocerviceitis. Thus tetracycline is very much useful in chlamydial infection. A leads to atypical pneumonia. Tetracycline is also used against the malaria and from the and A stand for amoebiasis and acne vulgaris. In acne vulgaris, the tetracycline group, we commonly use doxycycline. Thus, doxycycline is used mainly for the treatment of acne vulgaris. Tetracycline can also be used against urinary tract infection. Now, the drug is the chloramphenicol. Chloramphenicol is obtained from the Streptomyces venezuela. In 1947, it was obtained from the Streptomyces, but nowadays all the chloramphenicol, it is synthesized in the synthetic form, and we use the chloramphenicol in the synthetic form. It has got nitrobenzene group. This chloramphenicol has got nitrobenzene group, and this nitrobenzene group is responsible for bactericidal action as well as bactericidal action. When the chloramphenicol is used in the low dose, it will cause bacteriostatic action, and when the chloramphenicol is in high dose, it will cause cidal action. It means there is bactericidal action. Thus, chloramphenicol has got both bacteriostatic as well as bactericidal. The mechanism of action. As we have seen in the tetracycline inhibits the protein synthesis. This chloramphenicol also inhibit bacterial protein synthesis. Then how the bacterial protein synthesis is inhibited? It by interfering that with transfer of elongated peptide chains. As the peptide chain from the nascent peptide chain when get transferred to the acceptor site, and there is lead to formation of peptide bond formation for the elongation of chain. Thus, chloramphenicol binds with this 50S ribosome. Chloramphenicol binds with the 50S ribosome and inhibits this peptide bond formation. This inhibits the peptide bond formation. As soon as the peptide bond formation is inhibited, protein synthesis is restricted. Protein synthesis is restricted. Antimicrobial spectrum of chloramphenicol. As we have discussed, the tetracycline chloramphenicol is the broad spectrum, and it is broad spectrum and highly active against the gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria, as well as cocci, bacilli, as well as mycoplasma. One of the important point is the about the chloramphenicol is it is highly active against the Salmonella typhi. It means it is very much effective against the typhoid fever or the enteric fever. Initially, it was the drug of choice. Initially, chloramphenicol was the drug of choice for the Salmonella typhi. But nowadays, cephalosporin is the drug of choice. In villages, and still the chloramphenicol is used. It is used in the name of paraxin. But it is banned in India. The chloramphenicol is banned in India, but still in villages and some remote area, the chloramphenicol is nowadays is also used against the Salmonella typhi, and it is very much effective, but it is banned due to its adverse effect. Pharmacokinetics. It is taken orally. Volume of distribution is high, 1 liter per kg. These drugs, chloramphenicol, penetrates the blood-brain barrier. That's why it is also very much useful in the bacterial meningitis. If there is bacterial meningitis, the chloramphenicol is very much useful, and it is used against the bacterial meningitis. The half-life is 3 to 5 hours. Excretion of the chloramphenicol is occur by the liver as well as by the how it in the liver, it can chloramphenicol get conjugated with gluconic acid in the liver and excreted via the bile, whereas some amount of chloramphenicol is excreted unchanged from the urine. Uses of the chloramphenicol, as I have given the mnemonics. MOTA, MOTA. M for meningitis, the pyogenic meningitis. And whenever is a pyogenic, it means the pus is formed, it means there is bacterial meningitis. Thus, chloramphenicol is very much and highly useful in the pyogenic or the bacterial meningitis. Now it is the second line of drugs. First is the cephalosporin. O for ocular infection. In the endophthalmitis, the topical application of the chloramphenicol in case of conjunctivitis, it is chloramphenicol is used. Whereas in the ear infection, the topical application of the chloramphenicol is. The most important one is the typhoid. It is chloramphenicol is used in the enteric fever. Till 1980, it was the first drug of choice, but nowadays cephalosporin is the first drug of choice. Chloramphenicol is also against used against the anaerobic infection. Thus, MOTA, MOTA. It's the chloramphenicol is used against the MOTA. MOTA, M for meningitis, ocular infection such as Topical application, T for typhoid, A for anaerobic infection. Anaerobic infection includes such as pelvic abscess as well as intra-abdominal infection. It is also used against the UTI. And why now the important one? It is the adverse reaction. Adverse reaction, it is the bone marrow depression. It is the bone marrow depression. It leads to the aplastic anemia. It leads to the in PG examination, it is very much asked the chloramphenicol causes which type of anemia. Then chloramphenicol causes aplastic anemia and bone marrow depression. When there will be bone marrow depression, that it can cause pancytopenia, thrombocytopenia as well as agranulocytosis. The adverse effect of the chloramphenicol is very much useful and is asked in the PG examination as it causes bone marrow depression and aplastic anemia. And the idiosyncratic reaction, even a single drug of chloramphenicol can causes idiosyncratic reaction, which is highly fatal. Again, the other drug, other adverse effect is the Gray baby syndrome. When the it is given in the neonates, as the liver is immature, the patient complain, patient stop feeding, the neonate stop feeding, he vomits, there is irregular respiration, and the body of color is become cyanosed, that is gray cyanosed. That is why this drug causes Gray baby syndrome. Other side effect include hypersensitivity reaction, in which there will be rashes, fever and angioedema, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and there will be pain. And the superinfection means there is marked, when this drug is taken, there is marked suppression of the normal resident microflora of the body. When the drug is taken, the normal microflora of the body, which is useful for the human body, which is present in the mouth, vagina and skin, intestine, they all are being distorted. Thus, there will be super infection of Candida albicans. Thus, it is called leads to the infection by the Candida albicans most commonly. And this super infection is also seen in the tetracycline. And when there is super infection occur and the normal intestinal flora is disturbed, and there will be in Candida albicans, patient will complain of diarrhea. Thus, today we have finished our tetracycline and chloramphenicol. Thank you.